So the other thing, so we have now kind of discussed the concepts of stationarity and non-stationarity and so on. Let us say now the process is stationary, because we are going to confine ourselves to stationary processes. Now we address the other aspect or the other challenge in time series analysis. One challenge was to make sure that we are working with processes whose statistical properties do not change with time. Great. And now we come to a more practical aspect where we understand there is only a single realization that we are going to work with. What allows us, or what is the framework within which we can work with a single realization? And ergodicity is that property of a process which allows us to work with a single realization and draw inferences about the ensemble. Now, ergodicity is not just a term that's encountered in statistics. You encounter this term in thermodynamics and mathematics and so on, but we'll restrict ourselves to statistics or random processes. So what is ergodicity, or when do we say a process is ergodic? We have talked about this before. Let's make a formal statement here. A process is said to be ergodic if the time averaged estimates, whatever you are averaging in time, simple averaging in time, that converges to the true average. What do we mean by true average? The ensemble. And of course, it is implicitly understood that the process is stationary, otherwise it does not make any sense, right. So ergodicity is spoken of only for stationary processes. So this time average should coincide with the true average as the number of observations you take run to infinity. For example, if you take a stationary, in fact I should not say stationary is a redundant word there for IID, an IID process. What is an IID process? Independent and identically distributed process. Independence talks about the correlation structure of the process in time, and identical tells us that each observation falls out of the same probability distribution. Such a process is called IID. It is an idealization. It is an idealization that is not realized. IIT is realized, but IID is not realizable. A diluted version of IID process is white noise, and we will talk about those distinctions shortly. So if I take an IID random process, there is no need to say it is stationary. It is ergodic in the sense of mean, for example. So ergodicity is not a universal kind of property. You have to actually look at ergodic in what property. So if I were to look at the mean, is this IID process ergodic in mean? What this means is, if I were to compute the average in time, will that average converge to the true mean? Now, first of all, I am given that this is an IID process, which means the mean is going to be constant with time. So that is something that I have to ensure. If I were to apply a test of ergodicity or conduct a test of ergodicity, the first thing that I have to make sure is the process is stationary. I am given the process is stationary. Now the question is whether this 1 over n sigma xk, which is the time average of n observations, will that converge to mean as n goes to infinity. Now it is not so easy to show this as much as I have just written there. One has to essentially show that in the limit as n goes to infinity, this 1 over n sigma xk, or 1 to n, does not matter, is mu, where mu is the mean of the process. It is not so straightforward to show that this is true. I mean, this is of course known by the law of large numbers now. There are two versions of law of large numbers, weak law and strong law, based on the assumptions that you make of the process. But there is something else that I have written there. There is an abbreviation A dot S dot, right? What does that stand for? Almost sure. Why are we talking about this almost sure and so on? The reason is we are now looking at convergence of random numbers or random variables. Xk is not a deterministic variable, it is a random variable. So I am adding up random variables and I am talking of limits of such random variables, right? And we are asking if the limit of the summation converges to mu. Is mu a deterministic quantity or a random one? What do you think? Sure. Everyone is sure. Yeah, it, yes. So mu is a statistical property and for us it's a fixed one. We are talking if the sum of random numbers, the sequence of random numbers when I add up, this should converge to mu. What do we mean by sequence here? I evaluate the summation for n equals 1, then I evaluate the summation for n equals 2, right? So call each of those summations as Sn. So I have here S1, S2, S3 and so on. What is Si? Si is or Sn is this summation here, this average 1 over n sigma xk. So as I keep evaluating, it says ultimately I should hit mu. We are used to thinking of sequences of deterministic numbers, but not random numbers. Therefore, a separate theory of convergence is required, which we will not talk about now. We will talk about the very briefly the theory of convergence of random numbers in estimation theory. In estimation theory, we will ask the same question. As I increase the sample size, will the estimate converge to the truth? But underneath that statement is a Pandora's box that we have to open, because this convergence that we are talking about is not the straightforward convergence that we encounter. It's like what you see here, the convergence of random numbers to a fixed one. How can a random number converge to a fixed one? It's strange, right? It's a contradiction, because S1, is it a random number or not? It's a random variable, right? Because it's a sum of random variables. And so is every element of the sequence. How can a sequence of random variables converge to a deterministic one? Seems to be somewhat contradictory, correct? But it's possible in some sense. So we'll have to define in what sense do we mean convergence. We cannot do it in the plain vanilla sense that we apply to deterministic numbers. It's almost sure says that there exists some n after which it has reached the truth, okay, but when it reaches we do not know. In finite n it will reach, that is there somewhere and there exists a finite n after which it will reach, but what is that finite we do not know. Will this converge to 0 in 100 observations, 1000, 10,000, we do not know, but it will converge. That is what is almost sure convergence. There are two other forms of convergence known as the convergence in probability and what is known as a mean square convergence. What you see here in the statement is the strongest form of convergence, almost sure. You still want, you know, mathematicians try to be as correct as possible without getting into any legal issues. So almost sure says there is a probability, but I am almost sure. In fact, sometimes you will see a replacement for this almost sure as a statement with probability 1. Still there is a probability. I wonder what is this probability 1 business. We will talk about that later on. Right now what you should understand is we are looking at convergence of random numbers to a deterministic quantity, and we cannot use the plain definitions of convergence. And getting back to the discussion on ergodicity, you can show that this process is ergodic in mean. Now there is another process that we can look at and ask if it is ergodic. This process is a peculiar one. As you can see on the screen, this process actually holds on to a constant value. How can a constant signal be random? What is random about this signal that I have written, that we are looking at case 2? What is random about it? Any idea? I have said that A falls out of A is a random variable such that when I say expectation of A is 0, you should understand A is a random variable. It is a 0 mean random variable. That is all needs to be known. We do not worry about the distribution. How can you justify that X is random when X is constant actually? What is random about it? Sorry? Right. So the starting point, whatever it began, there is a randomness about it and then it has stuck to that random. So that is what imparts randomness to the signal. Suppose I have such a random signal, is it ergodic? What do you think? It still has the flavor of randomness. Don't think just because it's constant. One realization is constant. But if I look at the collections, they are not the same. And in that sense, it is random. So don't get confused here that xk is a deterministic signal. There is some randomness about the initial point. Once that is fixed, then conditioned on that, you can say it is deterministic. Now the question is whether this process is ergodic. What do you think? Yes or no? Any answers from the other hall? You just have to ask what is the time average and whether that coincides with the true average. What is the true average? Very good. That's a easy answer. What about the time average? A. So is this ergodic? It isn't. So this process is not ergodic, right? So there are examples of such processes and many such processes which are not ergodic, and we have also talked about ergodicity before. Ergodicity can be spoiled, can be lost by the way you are measuring. So suppose I have a sensor bias. For example, in process 1, which is IID, the true average is 0. Assume that it is 0 average process, right? Or you can say it is mu. But I can easily have a biased sensor which introduces bias at every instant in time. What happens is the time average would be a shifted version of the true average, and then the process is no longer ergodic. So sensor biases can actually spoil the ergodicity property. Therefore, one has to make sure that the instrumentation, the sensors or the measuring devices that you are using are free of biases. Not only in terms of hardware sensing, we have talked about an example also determining the, you know, average, the maximum number of people, the park to which the maximum number of people visit, or the theater that the maximum number of people go to, and so on. In that case also, the survey mechanism, the sampling mechanism that you use should be an unbiased one. You can't pick a person who doesn't go to park at all and come to a conclusion, right? So that will introduce a bias. You have already introduced a bias by selecting such an individual. So all kinds of sensor biases will spoil the ergodicity property. But of course, sensor biases in the hardware sensing are easier to detect when you know something a priori about the process and so on. So why are we discussing this ergodicity? Because we want to make sure that whatever inferences that we draw from a single realization holds for the ensemble. Why did we discuss stationarity? Whatever realization I draw from a single realization holds in future also. So stationarity allows us to walk ahead in time, march in time with the model that I have built, and ergodicity property allows us to make inferences about the entire process, that is walk along the ensemble direction. So therefore, we have taken care of things. Now, are there formal tests for ergodicity? Well, yes, some, but they are too complicated for us to learn. We will not worry about it. We will assume that the process is ergodic. Both the process and the measuring mechanism preserves the ergodicity property, and then keep moving along. When everything else fails, then we can revisit the ergodicity property. That's all we will do. So we will keep that at the back of our mind. So to close this discussion, ergodicity can be given a loose interpretation. It's a crude interpretation. If a process is ergodic, it more or less means that given sufficient time, you have unraveled all possibilities. Okay, but that's a very loose interpretation. Don't go by that formal interpretation. It's like I've given sufficient time, I've observed a process for sufficient time, and I've seen all possibilities, and therefore I've seen the ensemble kind of thing. Okay. And as I said, ergodicity is not necessarily a characteristic of the process, but also of the measuring mechanism. Okay, so that kind of brings close to the discussion on stationarity and ergodicity. And now, assuming that the process is stationary, assuming that the process is ergodic, we will study the theory of, first of all, determining whether a process is predictable. How do we build models for such processes, stationary ergodic processes? We don't keep repeating that the process is ergodic. Very soon we'll drop that term. we will only keep talking about stationarity, and that also we may drop for a while because we will confine ourselves to stationary processes.